my favorite artists. I have another project for you today. This project was a request from one of my students to draw a horse and buggy.
My horse to the old town road, I'm gonna...
Now, I'm gonna tell you right now, this is a bit of an art challenge because this one is not easy to draw. So, if you are a little intimidated by that and you're just a little nervous, that's okay. I do recommend that you try it, and if you don't like it, that's all right. I have a PDF version that you can print out of the horse and buggy where you can just use as a coloring page and you can color it however you'd like. But like I said, I do want you to challenge yourself to try and draw this. You might be surprised about what you can do. All right, for this project, you need some paper, a pencil, if you would like a permanent marker, and anything you want to color with, I have markers and crayons. All right, let's go get started.
I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna
Okay, my friends, so what we are going to do is we're going to start our picture. So we have our pencil ready, we have our paper, we're going to hold it landscape style, and we're going to start in the middle of our paper on the right side, and we're going to start by drawing with shapes, okay? So we're going to be doing the horse first. So I'm going to leave a little bit of space here for the horse's snout. And I'm going to start drawing lightly because we're going to be erasing these lines later. I'm going to start drawing a circle for the head. So artists do this. We draw with shapes in order to achieve, the right look that we're going for and the right shape that we're trying to draw in terms of animals or even people and objects. So off of this circle, we're going to be drawing a triangle. I know it looks silly right now. It looks kind of like a duck, but trust me, it will come together in the end. And then I'm going to come down a little bit here, and we have a circle for the body and another circle for the body. So this is like the horse's behind right here, and then this is like the belly going up into the neck, into the head, and then the snout. So we have two circles here, almost looks like wheels next to each other. And then we have a duck head. I know, kind of silly, right? Now let's start to connect all of these shapes together. So I'm gonna start at the base of the head, like on the side here, and I'm gonna curve my line down and then curve and come around like this. All right. And now I'm going to start about here, come down, curve around to about there. Okay. Now we're going to go back up and we're going to draw some pointy ears at the top. Two ears. And now we have to come down and curve that snout for the horse's face. Like so. Not too shabby. Now we're going to come down and we're going to draw the back legs. Now the back legs kind of curve back a little. Okay, so the kind of curve goes like this. Let me show you what I mean. So it curves like that, and then the leg will continue down like this, and then a straight line across. I'm going to do the same thing for the other leg on the other side, curve it back, and then mirror that line and draw a straight line across. If you want to go ahead and draw the hooves right now, you can. Just little lines. All right, now we're going to go to the front leg. Two straight lines down. Well, they're kind of curved a little bit. Two curved lines down with a line across the bottom. And now this front one is going to curve Like the horse is in motion. So I'm making kind of a hook shape and then straight line at the bottom and drawing my hoof. Not too bad. Okay, now we're going to go back in and erase those shapes that we did at the very beginning. Okay, we can add a tail. I like to do a little curved line and a swoop at the end. Swoop. And then bring it back up. And there's my tail. And we also have to draw some zigzaggy lines over here for the horse's mane at the top. Okay, let's draw a little dot for the nose and an oval shape for the eye, and then put in the pupil right there. Awesome. Now we can draw the reins, or the leather straps that go around the horse. We have two curved lines around the snout. And then we have a line coming down here. Two curved lines around the chest. Two around the belly. And two here. Now, I don't know if this is really accurate. I know some of my students are horseback riders, so I apologize if I got this part wrong. You can feel free to make it correct in your own drawings. Okay, we have the horse drawn. Now it's time to draw the carriage. We're gonna start with a big U shape right behind the horse. And this is kind of like an antique looking one, maybe from the early 1900s or late 1800s. So big U shape, and we have two big wheels at the bottom, so two circles. Draw them fairly big because we have a big carriage. Want it to look like it is able to be held up properly. And in the middle, we're gonna draw a circle. Small circle. And I'm gonna add even more details, and I'm gonna mirror my line on the outside, or on the inside of the circle, to give it the effect that it is made from wood. So we have two circles, one inside each other, and then a tiny one in the middle. And we can add the spokes, straight lines. I like to start with one down the middle, and another one down the middle, like that. And then I have it even, so I can add one inside each section. One down the middle, another one down the middle, like a plus sign, and then one in each section, like so. Okay, now we're gonna go in and we are going to draw the windows. We're gonna start in the middle here, and we're gonna draw two vertical lines right in the middle, so we have room at the bottom here for the door, and a little detail up at the top. We're gonna draw two horizontal lines connecting it, making a rectangle. We're gonna draw another window here. This one is going to go right to the edge, so once we draw a vertical line, we can go ahead and draw our horizontal line. And we're gonna do the same on the other side. Like so. Now we have a really fancy carriage here. So we are going to add some fancy details. So we are going to make some smile lines, one smile under each window. And then we're going to make some rainbow lines, one above each window. Just like that. Now I'm going to add a line on either side of the middle window, just for extra detail. Okay, now we're going to start from these points here and we're going to curve our lines down to make our door. There's our door and our handle. Okay, now we are going to add the top of our carriage by drawing a rainbow line. And then connecting these points here, curving them to the top. And they connect at the very top, like so. Okay, we're going to add some fancy curtains inside each window. We're going to start by making smile lines, small ones. Okay, and on the end windows, we're going to make a fancy kind of curtain hanging down. So we start from the corner here and we go whoop. And whoop, just like that. And I like to add a couple lines in there to make it look like the curtains are have folds in them and extra details. And there we go. Now, this is optional, but on each side, if you want to add a little swirly kind of coming off and make it even more fancy, you can do that. Just gives it a little extra detail. And then we can have the reins going from the horse to the carriage and maybe one behind the horse. So we have one coming from the back of the horse and then one giving the illusion that it's going behind and attached to the other side of the horse, like so. Okay, now, we can add a background. Feel free to add any kind of background you want. I'm just going to keep it really simple since we have a lot of detail in the foreground here. And I'm just going to draw a straight line across, making sure I'm not drawing through my objects because my objects are not see-through. And maybe I'll draw a sun in the corner here. And some clouds. Okay, now I'm going to go in with my permanent marker and I'm going to outline all of my pencil lines.
Staring up the road and pray to God I see headlights. I made it down the coast in 17 hours.
Okay, now I'm going to go in with my eraser and erase all of my pencil lines to clean up my work. Okay, you can color your picture however you like. Well, I hope you enjoyed making a horse and buggy with me today. As always, I love to see your artwork, so please send me a picture to dmaccabe@messenic.org. And until next time, happy creating.